Hi, my name is William Bellamy. I'm a principal escalation engineer supporting Microsoft Windows Azure. Today, I'll be demonstrating how to enable the Account Delegate feature in the Microsoft Account Portal. The Account Delegate feature enables multiple people to see the same Windows Azure billing information. The Delegate feature is useful because businesses often have multiple people involved in each account. I know this problem firsthand because I'm one of the account administrators for our team. In this demonstration, I will show you how to enable, verify, and disable the Account Delegate feature in the Microsoft Account Portal. This portal is different from the Windows Azure Account Center portal and from the Windows Azure Management portal. The first step is to navigate to the Microsoft Account Portal, which is https://commerce.microsoft.com. On the sign-in page, type your password. Once you are logged into the Microsoft Account Portal, you need to verify on the title bar that you are using a business account. In our case, US Business Account 1. Account delegates are not available on a personal account. Next, you need to click on the profile link. This displays your personal information. Notice that by looking at this page, there's no way to know if a delegate is configured. At the bottom of the page, there are two buttons. If you see only one button, you are probably using a personal account. The first button is Edit Profile, which changes the displayed information. The second, Delegate, is to administer account delegates. So clicking on the Delegate button, we can see that this account has no delegate assigned. To add an account delegate, click on the Add Account button. The Account Delegate feature is documented as follows. Account delegates have full access to your account. However, delegates cannot add, remove, or view other account delegates. Note, adding an account delegate does not give that person permission to use services that the account subscribes to. In other words, for Windows Azure, the delegate will not be a service administrator or a co-administrator. Now, let's enter a valid Microsoft account. Now click the Save button to add that account. Here we can confirm that the account was added to the list of delegates. You may be wondering if you can add multiple accounts, because perhaps your team, like mine, has backup account administrators. The answer is yes, you can add up to 10 account delegates. So let's add another one. Again, you click on the Add Account button, and you add a Microsoft account. And we click on Save. And we can confirm that there are now two account delegates. So let's close this dialog. This is the most important part of this video. The delegate information is not displayed. To view or remove a delegate account, click on the Delegate button. This is the only way to see this information, since currently it does not appear in the Windows Azure Account Center. You need to keep track of your account delegates, because if someone leaves your team, this could raise a security concern. To remove an account, click the X at the end of the row with the appropriate account delegate. In our case, we will remove the account delegate at live.com by clicking on the X. On the confirmation screen, we will click Yes. Now the account is no longer a delegate, so we can click on the X to leave that dialog. That concludes what we need to do in the Microsoft Account Portal, so we can sign out. We will now use our Account Delegate to log into the Windows Azure Account Center. The Account Delegate does not gain access to the information in the Windows Azure Management Portal. Account Delegates are different from co-administrators. We are now logged in as delegate@outlook.com. So we can drill down into the subscription. Looking at the details for this subscription, we can see that the account administrator has changed. But for now, there is no indication that this is a delegate. This could be a source of confusion, since both Microsoft accounts will see exactly the same information on the Account Center portal. In conclusion, remember it's up to you to keep track of your account delegates. In this video, I've demonstrated how to enable, view, and disable the Account Delegate feature in the Microsoft Account Portal. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing your great cloud services on Windows Azure.